So Malik and I are going to take you through our SharePoint Hackathon submission. So this is a little different than the other two demos today, but it's built around beautiful SharePoint portals. So we'll go through that the next 10 minutes or so. So before we get into that, again, just a brief introduction to who I am. My name is Richard Plantt. I am a creative lead, a consultant at Tuta Lead. My background is in graphic design, UX research. I've been using SharePoint for several years, many years, and just really excited to see how SharePoint has evolved and adapted and changed, even in this last year or so, just getting more intentional with the design and those kind of design feature updates. So we're going to take you through a few of those new features today as we go through it. We're always looking at Tuta Lead, how we can listen, measure, and build solutions within SharePoint that support our customers and that cutting edge in terms of the user experience. Mallika, over to you.
Yeah, thanks, Richard. Hey, everyone. It's great to be on this call with everyone. Really great demos from the two speakers. I'm a graphic designer at Tuta Lead, and I specialize in designing creative solutions in Tuta Lead for a variety of digital content, such as promotional materials, our website, social media, and more. I'm also an active member of the marketing team, where I lead marketing campaigns and implement SEO strategies. I'm actually new to SharePoint, and I've shared this as well, but the latest features like flexible layouts, design ideas, and editorial cards and more made it actually very easy for me to adapt even as a beginner, and I was able to start creating whole pages and sites by myself pretty quickly. And that's also why the SharePoint Hackathon was kind of a great learning experience for me, because I got to kind of use those tools more, and I'm looking forward to showcasing the pages that we built.
All right, thanks, Mallika. So yeah, our quick demo, basically, we're going to cover a couple different SharePoint pages. The first is a department site that we use internally at Tuta Lead for our marketing and communications team. We'll take you through that. And then the second example is an editorial type page where we're going to cover things like brand center, design ideas, flexible sections, as well as the new editorial card styles. You're going to see that in our live site. So we'll take you through that together. So I guess without any further ado, we'll switch over to SharePoint here. So to start things off, brand center. We love the new brand center. Going in, you'll see in our intranet, in our portal design, we're using custom fonts. We're using our own custom brand colors, and it was really quick and easy to go in, set those up, get those applied to our themes. As well, you can see the new theme center that we were using, going in, picking our primary colors or secondary colors, and all that has been just so intertwined so well with SharePoint and the site themes that way. So that was one of the first things we started with when working on these department sites or these different pages. So you can kind of see here, we have those custom fonts, the custom brand and theming set in place. Mallika, you want to take us through maybe some of the main sections on our marketing department site?
Yeah, of course. So yeah, like Richard said, this is our marketing and communications department site, and it's one of the pages that we built for the hackathon and submitted. First, you can see we have the hero zone, which features the carousel web part, and we kind of integrated this into the hero zone because we thought it was an engaging way to showcase top articles and special announcements in this department site. Its interactivity also adds visual interest to the site, allowing users to focus on the updates as soon as they land. And right below that, we have a few quick links. This is kind of the key tools and apps for the department or the employees to quickly access for their day-to-day activities. Next, we have the featured announcements as well as news from across our organization, which acts as links to another page. And this is followed by upcoming department events right below that. And having these updates all in one spot allows the employees to kind of stay updated easily without having to navigate around too much. So that was kind of the idea around that.
Thanks, Mallika. Yeah, so we're just going to go into edit mode too to kind of give you a peek behind the curtain of these different parts and sections that we have going on. Below that is where we get a little more interesting with the new flexible sections here that you can kind of see. Clicking on through, we have control over the layout of the actual section itself. And then in the design panel, we've really tried to push backgrounds, custom backgrounds. So you'll see a lot of different kind of scenarios that way. In this case, custom background image, we're experimenting with some overlays and how that background is anchored, along with additional images, text boxes. So because this is the flexible section, we can go in, we can move things around. Support for these editorial cards is great as well, going in, clicking in those. So these are, again, real world scenarios, real world use cases that we use day in and day out on our marketing and communications, linking to HR stuff, as well as our org asset library when we work on socials and designs for our marketing team. We also wanted to include our conversations web part to encourage collaboration, of course, throughout our team internally. We're remote, so getting everyone on board, asking those questions, very important to have those roll up and featured here. As well, moving further down the page, some more examples of that flexible sections. So one of the things that we also really loved about some of these new features were the templates that are included. It gives you a great way to jumpstart if you're not even sure where to begin when working with flexible sections or any other kind of design in your SharePoint. So you can see a lot of these sections that we built and used, we started with some of these section templates to give us a bit of a head start there. And there's so many to choose from. I would encourage everyone to check those out if you haven't already. And it's just a great way to get some of those ideas flowing if you're not sure where to start. As well, you'll see we went all out in terms of the flexible sections, trying to kind of see the limits or that we can push things to. So we added a lot of different elements, probably wouldn't do this normally. But again, you'll see all these are individual images on their own layers, and we can group them, we can change them in their position in the layers, as well as the text boxes below. Same with these little persona icons. In the past, we would have saved this out as one flat image and then added it to the page. Now we can add them individually. We can layer them so you can change the order and just freeform move things around. So it's really great in terms of the flexibility that you have with these different zones. I guess that's pretty good for our department page. Maybe we'll switch gears, go into our editorial type layout next. So again, this would be more of a one-off or a custom kind of a news article. We wanted to showcase and highlight some of these new features, of course, for the design and the page layout in SharePoint. And if we go into edit here, again, you'll notice that this hero zone in the header section is using that flexible sections piece again. Every text piece is on its own layer. That was by design, that was intentional. Even the image here is a transparent image. It really felt like we were designing right in SharePoint, which I've never experienced that kind of before. So it was really interesting in terms of creating these pages, going in and color, fonts, typography, imagery, everything kind of coming together in these different sections, moving them around freeform, creating them on the page that way. So just moving further down and watching our time, Mallika, maybe you want to talk about the next few areas here.
Yeah, of course. Thanks, Richard. Yeah, like Richard said, flexible sections, the grids and guides, being able to anchor things, right, group things, makes it really easy. Like over here, we have some text as well, using different styles of text, which is also a really great way to kind of put in that stylistic effect. And over here, we have images that we kind of imported into SharePoint as well and made groups of it. And you can see like we have a background layer there that's just kind of like a gradient going down, guiding users' eyes below to the next section. Yeah, and here we have some editorial cards, which we thought was a nice way to kind of break up the text in between the sections. And we customized it to draw users' attention to the call to action buttons, which is to either download the report or take the survey. And in the edit mode, as you can see, Richard is showing you, we chose the image overlay layout to combine the visuals and the text. And we customized it even further by adding a background image to each of the cards. And we chose kind of photos with like a similar stylistic version to all the other photos that we've used so far in our department sites and this page. And we also added a dark overlay color and opacity. And by adding this contrast, we thought that it would make the text and call to action button even more visible and accessible for users to read. And we also anchored some of the images and graphics to experiment and customize the section even more. And we thought that contrast is a very big element in this layout, which is why we have kind of a dark and light contrast, as you've seen so far. It really helped break up the different page elements and keep it visually appealing to maintain the reader's attention. Richard, do you want to talk about the code section here?
Yeah, absolutely. So yeah, we built a number of different sections, probably more than what we would normally do. But again, this was just giving us hands-on experience in how to use some of these new features. Really easy, really straightforward to go in and add something like a custom quote. So we added our own, you know, image quote marks using the styles in the editor of the pull quote. And then again, flexible sections to add custom background and elements like the attribute of the quote itself. Other things here we'll just kind of wrap up and highlight is just the ability to even import images like SVGs, very crisp vector type graphics for our infographics, really an impressive way to add and tell stories on these different SharePoint pages that way. So a number of different styles, again, using color and contrast as we go through the different sections to make it almost like an editorial type article that you're reading and looking at. And then finally, we have a third kind of iteration of our editorial cards with a custom background that kind of parts through all by design. We were able to do this all without in the out of the box SharePoint web parts and create something really captivating at the end of the day. So I guess in closing, we just hope that you, as a takeaway from this demo, this quick demo, is that you can create some pretty impressive custom kind of designs in your SharePoint using the Brand Center. You can get your own colors, your own fonts, using design ideas and some of those patterns in the background. If you're not sure where to start, those are great to get things going, get those creative juices flowing and get you started that way. Again, just go in, tweak a few things, make it your own. Those worked really well for us. Flexible sections, totally new, game changer, like we were saying. Haven't experienced anything like that before in SharePoint. And just, I feel like we're scratching the surface with some of that too. I know working with our customers, this is stuff they've been asking for years, having their own brand, their own colors, and just the ability to move things around on the page. And it's an exciting time to be designing in SharePoint. And the very last thing I just want to shout out is the accessibility assistant. We loved that. Going through, we were able to test our contrast and our alt text on our pages that way. So yeah, that's about it. Mallika, any final words there as well?
Yeah, no, this was great. Thank you so much for inviting us to this call so that we can demo this to everyone. It was a great chance for both of us to get more of like a hands-on experience with the new SharePoint features to innovate. And again, like I said, I was a beginner and I could kind of see what I could come up with as well. And here in our org, we're always encouraged to kind of try like a try and fail fast method. So similar to this, the hackathon was a great call out for how we work by continuously adapting and always shipping. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone. All right.